All right, welcome back. Plan today, in this video, we are going to talk about how to open up your site plan file using the S drive at Maine Township High School, specifically Maine South, and how to then link your existing Habitat House file, which is let's say what I have going on here. Maybe I've not done yet, but I have walls, I have a foundation in, and I now want to share the information from this file into my site plan file. So first order of business is to make sure that you save the file that you're working on for your Habitat House, because we are now going to close this file completely. Okay, it is a very good habit to not have two different files open. Okay, so we're going to close that particular file, and we're now going to go open an existing template file or a student shared file for our site plan. So you'll need to make your way to your school desktop, this PC. We're going to go to the S drive, the shared drive, Maine South, Students, AAT, Applied Tech, CEA. Now, in this case, we are working on Activity 237, so we're going to be in Unit 2. I'm going to open that up. 237 is what we're working in, and I'm specifically going to be looking for the 237 site plan, and please ensure that you grab the original file, not one of these backups. I will be, in fact, I'm going to delete them right now, and hopefully we won't see those, or you won't see those when you have the option to go and open the file. And we want to open this 237 file. Okay, look at it as the template file that we used to start our Habitat House, but in this case there's going to be some existing stuff going on here. So once you open up that file, the first thing you should do is a save as project. And you'll want to save this to your U drive, right? So the file that's got your name on it. Again, for my demonstration purposes, I'm going to be saving it onto my desktop where I've got the example house that you saw previously. It's important to know where you're saving this. As if we move either this file or the house file that we'll be using, you can have broken links, and that's something that we have to deal with. So right now I'm going to go and call this Habitat House Site Plan. Okay. Again, you need to know where you're saving things and what they are being called. So we look over in our project browser, and we've got a couple things that are different. We see there's Habitat for Humanity under floor plans, and we have a 3D view. Okay, if we take a look here in the 3D view, and you'll see that there is some stuff here. We've got two streets. This is probably 10th Street, I believe, and this one's Maple. We can certainly check that by going to sheet A101, which is what we are now, or I've asked you to work on a site opportunities map as well as a preliminary site plan file, sketching wise. So this is the sheet that we've seen being printed. You'll see that there are setbacks here that we'll want to pay attention to as well, and eventually in future videos, we'll talk about adding some utilities in. But right now, we just want to get our file linked, okay? So what I usually like to do is I like to go to that actual Habitat for Humanity floor plan, okay? And that's what we're looking at here, okay? And we're going to go up to insert, okay? So I don't think we've looked at this before, but we're going to be inserting and linking a Revit file. So I'm going to select that option, and now I'm provided the option to link a file. And in this case, I want to link my Habitat house. Please be sure, everybody, that you do not link a backup file. If you do not pay attention and you link a backup file, well, eventually that backup file will no longer exist because of those rolling numbers for backups. So you want to make sure you get the original house file, okay? And really after that, we're not going to play with anything down here, and we're going to say okay. Now, what has just come in is an example file, right? Here's my house. The house is going to come in kind of like what we would call a block. It's going to come in as one piece. You are not able to edit the house in this file. We have to go back to the house file to work on it. Also, the default setting right now, I can see through my house, and that's not what I should see here. Everybody's probably going to have to go down here to our graphics display and turn that to hidden line. And when I did that, you'll see that that disappeared. However, there's an outline there, okay? So what just happened, okay? Let's go take a look at one of the elevations. It doesn't matter which, I picked south. And you'll see here, this area up at the top here is my site, okay? And if we take a look at the site plan itself, you'll see that these contour lines, I am up at 769 feet above sea level or zero or grade. And in class, we had talked about utilizing our levels, and our ground level is going to be zero. And you can see here, it came in on level one and two. It came in at the zero level because we had our ground level identified in the actual file. So what we're going to need to do, okay, at a basic level, I'm going to zoom out far enough, and I'm just going to click and drag my house up, okay? I'm moving it in three-dimensional space, and I want to get this to the point where I believe my foundation is sticking up above ground level, so I can see a little bit of that foundation sticking up above ground level. Right now, that's close enough for the game that we're ready to play, which is linking this file. If we take a look at the 3D view here, you'll see that I have a heck of a lot of the foundation sticking up above ground level, right? Excuse me, right now. So if we take a look again at our site plan file, you'll see now I'm seeing the roof of the house and where it is on the site, okay? If I want to move that house around at this point in time, I am now back into my floor plan where I can highlight and select that house, and I can place it wherever on the site I want to place it, but that wouldn't be the correct statement, as in another video, we will need to talk about putting in the information for our setbacks, okay? And then we'll also be talking about how to put in sidewalks and driveways and patios or decks and landscaping and all the other things that might go along with our site plan, including these utilities, okay? So if you've got that inserted, you should definitely be saving that work so the link is created. And beyond that, I guess I might as well talk about a couple other things, okay? So if all you're worried about is getting things linked, that's how you link in this particular situation. If at some point in time you find your link is broken, up here under Manage Links, you click on that, it will bring up this window, and you'll see here that I have this house loaded, okay? There apparently was another file, which I'm going to remove, and I'm assuming that will be on all of your files as well. But this is the file that I have loaded. If at any point in time it is ever broken, I can reload and or respecify the location or the path on how to get to that file. Okay. So if I unload this real quick, that house is gone, right? It's no longer loaded. And all I would have to do in the future is reload from and go find that particular file and hit open. And that now is loaded again, right? So again, I reloaded it, but it might not be at the correct height any longer if I've moved it or I had to reload it, okay? So again, real quick demo on how to load your house file onto your site. Again, in a future video, we will talk about adding the setbacks, how to put in additional items like driveways and sidewalks and other things, and eventually the utilities. So don't think that your house is set in stone at this point in time. What I would suggest is the setbacks will be impacting the rectangular area between the streets and where we can actually place our house. And for the most part, probably in this general area here in the middle, anywhere there should be okay. And if necessary, you can also rotate your house on the site as you might see fit or want to do, depending upon where your front entrance is going to be, either heading towards Maple Street or 10th Street. All right. Thanks for watching. Hope that was useful, and we'll see you on the next video.